Hiya, my name is Sophie Taylor. I'm an actress and I do IBS awareness through social media.
It's amazing to have you here for us tonight. You're looking forward to the film?
I'm so looking forward to the film. I've obviously seen the trailer. I'm really excited. I love the fact that it stands for femalehood and it inspires, you know, young females to want to do football. And I just absolutely love that. So yeah, I'm super excited, super excited.
And in terms of your own mission, your own activism, can you tell us a little bit more about that?
So yeah, so I do IBS awareness. It's something that affects one in three females. It's actually something that I'm suffering with at the moment. I had a really bad IBS flare-up last night. So I'm very bloated today. I'm in a lot of pain. And, you know, sometimes you don't want to come out. You don't want to be at events such as this. But I think it's really important to speak about that. It affects mainly women. And I think the more that we can speak about IBS and just break that taboo and raise awareness, the more that people will feel more confident in their own bodies, really.
I mean, why do you think there are specific medical conditions like IBS that are somehow taboo to talk about and to be open about in our society?
I think there's such a taboo because with IBS, you know, you're sitting on the toilet for hours. It's not something that maybe people feel is attractive to talk about, maybe. You know, it's not something that people take very seriously as well. You know, if you can't go to work for because you've got IBS, for example, it's sometimes not taken that seriously. So I think people feel embarrassed, the symptoms they feel embarrassed about. And it is embarrassing, but we have to just talk about that. And we have to break that taboo and we have to just keep on raising awareness.
And aside from educating people and clearing up misconceptions, are there any concrete changes, like particularly with workplace laws and things like that, that you would like to see to help support people with IBS?
I definitely think there needs to be more education for employers, for managers, about IBS, so that if they do have people that have IBS on their team, for example, they can give them that support, that time off, and just support them, really. I think there needs to be a lot more education around IBS and just how severely it can affect people, because it can, it's not classed as a disability, but it can affect you like a disability, and it does me every day. So yeah, we just need education, definitely.
Best of luck with that work and enjoy the screening tonight.